I feel like I'm about to dive face first into hot water with this video. The holidays are here, and that means thousands of hobbyists have an adequate excuse to splurge on another RC they really wanted but may not have needed. It also means that a good amount of people maybe is looking to buy their first hobby-grade RC but don't really know where to start. One of the major variables that tends to drive people mad is what brand to start with. Asking what to start with online in forums can warrant either genuine answers from level-headed hobbyists or biased drivel from fanboys. Today I'm going to try and be the former, and go over some RC brands that one might want to take a look at this holiday season. One last thing I want to say before I begin is that I'm one person. Some brands I have personal experience with and others I don't. I'll make sure to note when I'm talking from personal experience and when I'm going off of someone else's experience. It's also important to know that since this is more of a racing channel, I'll be going over racing brands only, so brands like Arma and Traxxas won't be featured here. With that out of the way, let's get started. Possibly the most popular RC racing brand has got to be Team Associated, at least in the US. Team Associated is the premier brand for most tracks, and usually if you can't find any other brands being sold at a racing hobby shop, you can usually find a Team Associated kit lying around somewhere. As of right now, they make two-wheel drive buggies, four-wheel drive buggies, two-wheel drive short course trucks, two-wheel drive stadium trucks, dirt oval cars, and very recently, drag cars. One of the main benefits of Team Associated, like I mentioned before, is their popularity in the US. Most hobby shops that aren't in some kind of contract with Traxxas will have plenty of Team Associated parts, and because of the chassis Team Associated use are all of the same mold and layout, most parts are interchangeable, though this specific benefit isn't unique to Team Associated. Because of this, and because of their fairly good durability, this is possibly the best racing brand for beginners. They don't break too often, no matter how badly you drive, and if you do end up breaking, you can usually find a replacement quite easily. This is personally why I have run Team Associated for years, despite their drawbacks, however few they may be. The main drawback being the fact that a lot of the parts that come with the actual cars are usually made of composites or plastic. Specifically, parts that have a high risk of breaking under a lot of stress, like bulkheads, are made out of composites. In this car specifically, the plastic bulkhead broke twice under regular uses before I upgraded to aluminum and eventually brass. Now this problem isn't exclusive to Team Associated, and I'll bring this up later in the video, but it's something to take into account. As a whole, you can't really go wrong with Team Associated, as they are the standard when it comes to RC racing. Now if you don't want the standard and you want to be a little bit different, might I recommend Team Losi Racing? Losi has been around in RC racing for a decent amount of time and are basically the antithesis to Team Associated. At least in the US. I know it's a bit different across the world. Think the Subaru WRX STI versus the Mitsubishi Evo or the Dodge Viper versus the Corvette. That's the dynamic between the Team Associated and Losi and their fans. Losi makes two-wheel drive buggies, four-wheel drive buggies, two-wheel drive stadium trucks, two-wheel drive short course trucks, and four-wheel drive short course trucks. Much like Team Associated, most of the parts from one car, like the two-wheel drive stadium truck, will work on something like the two-wheel drive buggy or short course truck. One plus they have over Team Associated, however, is that their kits tend to come with a bit more and are slightly more convenient to build. Two examples of this are the fact that 1. Losi bodies come pre-cut, and 2. They come with wheels, though not tires or foams. Another plus about Losi is part availability. Other than Team Associated in the US, the most common parts for racing vehicles you're going to find here are going to be for Losi. And like Team Associated, those parts will be quite affordable. This is mostly because of the fact that they're owned by Tower Hobbies, the Volkswagen of RC brands. Parts are everywhere, but unfortunately this is where I have to get into the negatives of Losi, and that starts with durability. I've raced for a little while at this small little track, and I have to say that within reason, Losis are durable enough, but they don't pass that threshold very convincingly. Out of all the cars that I've seen race over the last year or so, the one I've seen crack the most has unfortunately been Losi cars, specifically the wheels falling off. I find this odd because some people who run Losi cars where I race haven't broken a thing, whereas others break almost every time they go out. Maybe this is due to some people taking care of their stuff better than others, but I wouldn't be able to confirm this. I feel like I need to say this again, but I'm only one person, and I can only go off of my own experiences and the experiences of others around me, so take my own word as you will. As a whole, Losi is a pretty good brand for beginners, and if you don't want to go along the grain but still need part support, I'd go with Losi. But if you want to go even further off the grain, well, this is where we start to talk about brands that I'm just going to get out of the way now so I won't have to say over and over again. I wouldn't recommend for beginners unless your local track or hobby shop supplies parts for them. The first brand I want to go over in this category is Schumacher. Schumacher is the most popular RC brand across the pond in Europe, and more specifically the UK. Makes sense seeing how that's their native country. Now for the most part, it seems like Schumacher focuses more on on-road racing, but they do have a very good history when it comes to off-road as well. As for the cars they make for off-road, they make two-wheel drive buggies, four-wheel drive buggies, and stadium trucks. Not a very extensive list, but at least the Storm ST and the Cougar buggy both share many parts. Now I actually reviewed the Cougar laydown stocks back a while ago when my mic made it sound like I was whistling through my teeth. So if you can suffer through that, I recommend taking a look at it to get a good idea of my own experience with it. If you just want the bluff notes, here you go. I enjoyed the way the car drove and admired the design from a performance perspective, but working on it was a bit odd, it didn't come with sway bars out of the box, and replacement parts here in the US can be hard to come by. This brings me to the biggest negative of Schumacher as a whole, the lack of part support in the US. If you live near a hobby shop that regularly has Schumacher parts in stock, consider yourself lucky. Not only that, but the price of those parts can be a bit expensive. There's a very good reason why those parts are like that though. It's because the quality of these parts are very good for the most part. I've never driven a car with a GoPro on its back with no sway bars that wanted to turn so much and handled so well. I won't lie, if I had the means and two in the time, I might primarily run Schumacher based off their performance. They really are that good. If you want something that will perform well with a bit of work put in, I'd recommend Schumacher highly. Now before I go over the last brand I have experience with, let me rapid fire some brands I haven't mentioned yet. Tecno are probably the most durable RC racing brand out there full stop. Unfortunately, they don't make very much for 10th scale racing. In fact, they only make a 10th scale 4-wheel drive buggy, truggy, and short course truck. Other than that, they mostly focus on 8th scale racing, and as a result, I don't have too much experience with them. Yokomo are the most popular RC racing brand in Japan and are very similar to Team Associated in many ways. Oh, if you put both of their 2-wheel drive buggies next to each other, you'd be hard-pressed to find any notable difference. Unfortunately though, because they are a quote-unquote foreign brand, or because they hold their stuff to a higher quality, Yokomos tend to be a bit on the expensive side. They make 2-wheel drive buggies, 4-wheel drive buggies, and 2-wheel drive stadium trucks. Next up we have Kyosho. Kyosho are a bit of an oddball here in the US, and to be honest, I've never actually seen someone run one at this specific track, though I am aware they have a large enough following. They make 2-wheel drive buggies, 4-wheel drive buggies, and 2-wheel drive short course trucks, but those trucks can be quite expensive. Hot Bodies I know almost nothing about other than they are partner with or own HBI, and they make a 4-wheel drive buggy and an 8th scale buggy and truggy, I think. Lastly, we have Serpent being another oddball in the off-road racing world, being one of the few brands that still make an RTR racing 2-wheel drive buggy. They also make a 4-wheel drive buggy and a short course truck. The last brand I want to go over is X-Ray. I personally have a relationship with X-Ray as the first RC car I raced was an X-Ray T3 touring car at an old Marietta track called Hotshot RC. These days, they make 2-wheel drive buggies, 4-wheel drive buggies, 2-wheel drive stadium trucks, 4-wheel drive 10th scale truggies, and 2-wheel drive short course trucks. X-Ray are very similar to Schumacher in that their prices reflect the quality of their parts. The main difference is that they tend to be a bit more plentiful here in the US due to their heightened popularity when it comes to racing, especially on the West Coast. Another benefit of them being in the US is that the parts are a bit easier to come by. Again, this is from the perspective of someone in the US. If you live in Japan, I imagine Yokomo and Kyosho parts are easier to come by, and if you live in the UK, Schumacher parts are easier to come by. Another good thing about X-Ray is the fact that they seem to be quite durable. Granted, the only people I see running X-Rays at my local track are sponsored and are pretty good at driving, so I don't really see them break too often anyway. As a whole, X-Ray is a very good brand whose quality reflects their price. Their biggest drawback, though, is exactly that, their prices. $400 for a 2-wheel drive buggy can be a very hard sell for someone just getting into the hobby. For that price, I can get a Team Associated or Losi buggy at a decent chunk of the amount of electronics I'd need to make it go. If you're already into RC and money is no object for you, or you want the absolute best quality parts out of the box, I'd recommend X-Ray highly. Those are some of the RC brands I have experience with as a whole. If I did your favorite brand dirty, I'm sorry, and feel free to correct me in the comments below with your own experiences. If you liked the video, hit the like button, and if you want to see more, subscribe. I'll see you later.